Good day, Father June, and to everyone. In this video presentation, I would tackle about one of the particular topic belongs to the Unit 3 of the book Ecclesiastical Latin by John Collins. I chose the first topic of Unit 3, which talks about the second declension noun, neuter nouns. As we all know that neuter nouns are nouns that have neuter gender. Neuter gender means a gender which is not a masculine nor a feminine. And these neuter nouns are classified in the second declension. Neuter nouns of the second declension have a nominative and accusative singular ending, and a nominative and accusative plural ending, a. To decline a second declension neuter noun, derive the base by removing the I ending from the genitive singular form, then add the designated endings. So the endings of the second declension neuter nouns are as follows. For singular nominative, the ending is For singular genitive, the ending is e. For singular dative, the ending is u. For singular accusative, the ending is For singular ablative, the ending is o. For plural nominative, the ending is a. For plural genitive, the ending is urum. For plural dative, the ending is is. For plural accusative, the ending is a. And for plural ablative, the ending is is. Like for example, the Latin word verbum verbi, a second declension noun, which means word. So to decline it, let's derive the base by removing the I ending of its genitive form, which is verbi. So we have already the base, which is verb. Then we're going to add the designated endings for neuter nouns. For singular nominative, it will become verbum. For singular genitive, it will become verbi. For singular dative, it will become verbo. For singular accusative, it will become verbum. For singular ablative, it will become verbo. For plural nominative, it will become verba. For plural genitive, it will become verburum. For plural dative, it will become verbis. For plural accusative, it will become verba. For plural ablative, it will become verbis. So let us translate it into English. For singular, verbo means the word. Verbi means of the word. Verbo means for or to the word. Verbo means the word. Verbo means for, verbo means from, with, in, by the word. So in plural, verba means the words, verburum means of the words, verbis means for or to the words, verba means the words, verbis means from, with, in, by the words. So let us take note that first, except for the nominative and accusative endings, these neuter noun endings are identical with those used for masculine nouns of the second declension. Then second, neuter nouns of whatever declension will duplicate the nominative form, singular or plural, in accusative. And the third, neuter nouns of whatever declension will end in a, in the nominative and accusative plural forms.